Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play War and Peace on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install War and Peace and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play War and Peace. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to get started we have to launch our main browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type anything, because there's a link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived right here on our website of Usitility, in which we find here a precise demonstration on the way to download and install War and Peace on personal computer. We browse down a bit and mouse click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to play War and Peace on our PC. As you can discover here we access some advantages of using this emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the War and Peace by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download action starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to launch the installer, okay, then we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the device. We answered yes. I reduced the browser to see the installer significantly better. The installation software is straightforward. It consists of a couple of options, install, and setup path. I will talk about what setup path does indeed. We only simply click on it. And now we observe that we have here the path in which the emulator is going to be set up. If we would like to vary this folder we have got to click on the browse button, and now we choose another folder and install the emulator precisely where we choose. I prefer to leave it by default. I click on back, and therefore I simply click on install. Great, the installation starts and it is going to proceed along with the download of all these MB that happens to be represented on this computer screen. When you save it on your hard disk, it could be more or less MB. The data transfer speed will go faster or slower, based on your web access and depending on the velocity of the emulator hosting servers. Now they are running incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been launched successfully. As you will notice, down here, there is a progress bar that will fill up and once it actually reaches the ending, the emulator can be started for the very first time. The reality is the emulator was already launched, there for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can see now, it has created a couple of icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is definitely the only one we're concerned with. Whenever we have to operate War and Peace on our PC, we twice click on that app icon and as a result start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should perform the next step, which is a requirement, and which is to visit the Google Play Store. And we are going to simply click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is launched. Here we are required to sign in. At present as soon as we are here, we have to conduct this next phase that is definitely compulsory. So that we mouse click on Sign In. At this point it says, Checking Info. It can once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, and so it isn't going to continue. In that case, you could try to log in after a couple of hours and it will surely quite likely be sorted out. At this point we will enter our username and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For instance you can use the exact same email you are using at the moment in your YouTube account. So that I am going to insert my information and I will return when I have accomplished it. That's all, details entered. Find out Google welcoming us and offering us their twos. We must approve them all by simply clicking, I agree. After that, it offers us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can let it select it, it's going to build a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can use that option if you wish. We just click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched by default and completely on its own. To install the app, we are required to browse the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on that app icon designated in green. Today that we are watching the desktop of the emulator for Android, we see that we come with there the install application option. We click or double-click on that button. Right here we get the game. Let's click right here on the install link that I am just showing now in green color. Therefore it will begin the installation. At this moment it would download and install the game app, it normally takes quite some time or it could possibly be extremely fast. It all is going to depend on our connection to the web. This has by then finished installing. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting this button that I'm showing in green, so that you can start War and Peace for the first time. I am by now on the emulator desktop, and we're preparing to just click the brand new War and Peace software icon which has been provided. That video game is launched for the first time. There we get it, I am able to press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume of that emulator. It is right here. We use the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the fullest, we can switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is the first one, we mouse click on this particular app icon which I am identifying in green color. Then the screen is maximized, having one border on top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we wish to launch the game in full screen, we select the game icon. And we might already be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen function. To get out of the complete screen functionality, click the F11 key. And we'd already play in normal display setting. At this moment I am starting to clarify you the keyboard mapping and that is quite cool. That strategy we definitely will be in a position to operate the game much more easily. The first point is to click this application icon. It's now time to make the necessary configuration settings. Let me put the normal settings, however if you want to modify it, you can do it now without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our language. In certain cases it happens that your emulator is presented in the improper language, for instance, in Japanese. Then to set it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. So here within other options, we click the language drop down. We should select the language we prefer, German, Chinese, and so forth. When the language is selected, we would save, the emulator will restart, as well as the game application, the next time we run it, would also be in the specified language. At this time, there's another detail that we must take into consideration, and this is that we will get an email telling that a brand new electronic device has been connected to this Google account. It definitely will ask us if we are the ones who have associated with that device. Absolutely, we may not be troubled, since the emulator is simulating an Android electronic device. And then to discover which device is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And so we go here to the model option. And here we notice that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for the tutorial. I anticipate you appreciated it, specifically that everyone thought it was informative. If so, offer it a great like, subscribe, and if you have remarks, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment box below. You could possibly also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams from time to time, you have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Just click any of these training videos which are usually showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye.